بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. الحمد للہ وکفا وسلام علی عباده الذین اصطفى اما بعد، قال اللہ تبارک و تعالی فی الکلام المجید والفرقان الحمید، بعد اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم، بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِكُمْ نَارًا قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَلِّمُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ وَأَهْلِكُمْ خَيْرًا وَأَدِّبُوهُمْ. أيضاً قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ كُلُّكُمْ رَاعٍ وَكُلُّكُمْ مَسْئُولٌ عن رعیته. صدق اللہ مولانا العظیم و صدق رسول النبی الکریم و نحن ولا ذالک من الشاہدین و شاکرین و الحمد للہ رب العالمین. صلو علی نبی، نبی کے ذات پر درود پڑھیں. اللہم صلی علی سیدنا محمد و علی آل سیدنا محمد و بارک و سلم و صلی علیہ. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم وصل عليه. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم وصل عليه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي ربي زدني علما. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. My most respected brothers and honorable sisters in Islam, ناظرین، السلام علیکم رحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. First of all, we should bring our hearts and mind in the state of shukr. Ya Allah, trillion time uncountable. MashaAllah, we thank you very much. شکر الحمد للہ رب العالمین. یا اللہ تھینک یو ویری مچ، یو بلیسڈ اس وتھ اسلام وتھ ایمان اینڈ گیو اس توفیق ٹو کم ٹو دا مسجد صلاۃ الجمعہ. الحمد للہ رب العالمین، ماشاء اللہ. دا ٹاپک وٹ آئی ایم کورنگ ٹوڈے از ویری کروشل، ویری امپارٹنٹ، اسپیشلی فار دا پیرنٹس اینڈ چلڈرن آلسو. دا ٹاپک ہاؤ ٹو ریز چلڈرن ایز اے گڈ مسلم in this country, any country. How to raise children as a good Muslim. I quoted before you Ayat-e Mubarakah. The part of Ayat-e Mubarakah from Surah At-Tahrim, Ayat number 6. First part. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, O believer, who claim to love me as Allah, who claim to love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who claim we are Muslim, I am Mu'min, we giving you command. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, who anfasakum, we love you because you love us, you believe in me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you believe in me, my Rasul, akhirat. So I love you also. I want to give you jannah. Therefore, command coming to you. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, who anfasakum wa ahlikum nara, save yourself and your family member from hellfire. This is a hukam. Of course we want to save. We don't want to go to hellfire. How? We work on us. We keep our iman and amal saleh intact. And also take care of our children also. We are responsible. As quoted in this part, Allimu awlaadakum, teach your children Islam, good manners, wa ahlikum khairan, and your wife also. This is man's responsibility. Man is the leader of the family. The wife has to listen to the husband until unless he does not go out of Sharia. Both are responsible to raise children. وَأَدَّبُوهُمْ and also teach your children good etiquettes, good manners, good Islamic manners. This is the responsibility of the man and woman, husband and wife, father and mother, to save ourselves and the whole family from the hellfire. We will not, at the time of death, we don't have a correct iman. There is danger. And sacred hadith Pak I quoted before you, Kullukum Ra'in, everybody among you is a shepherd, is responsible, and it will be asked responsibility. Did you, oh daddy and mommy, oh father and mother, did both of you, we commanded you, render your responsibility to raise children and yourself as a good Muslim. Few tips I give you today. First of all, if we want good children, we have to pick up good wife. Right? What should be foundation? We should pick up the wife on the basis of the seerah. Good Muslim, practicing Muslim. But normally we first check how she look like. Surat. No. Seerat ke hum ghulam hain. Surat hui to kya? Surkho safayad matti ki murat hui to kya? We are slave. We love seerah. Of course, with the seerah, the sister is pretty also. Subhanallah, nur ala nur. You understand? Subhanallah. The foundation should be, please, is a seerah. If she is good Muslim, practicing Muslim, she got some knowledge of deen, of course, she will help you. She will teach the children. Why? The primary responsibility is the wife. Because man, we are a field person. Morning go to job, two job, three job, come back home. But we have to support the wife. It's very simple and straight. Now, we are very keen about the health of the child. We have pediatrician. When baby born, every week you have to go to. Baby gets sick, we go to. Yes or no? We are made of seerah. We are made of two things: spirit, ruh, and a body. Everybody has a pediatrician. What about his spirituality? The physic, the body is temporary. The ruh is permanent. It is a more high responsibility to take a religious education of the child than the worldly education. I don't say we should not become doctor or engineer. But let me tell you, you have son, he's a doctor. But he don't know how to make salat. I die, my son is a doctor. He don't know how to make janaza prayer, right? But I got. At least my son, he knows the deen. If I die, he will make dua for me. Yes or no? It's very simple. We have to earn halal earning, halal income. Make sure halal tayyib income, halal tayyib food. This is a prerequisite. If haram income, haram food, who will eat, he will do haram amal. What we drink, what we eat, it affects on the body. Especially children. This king, Burger King, this king, that king. I know I have children, they like outside food. But I will request mommy, they should go, the mommy should cook food with zikr Allah. Halal, tayyab, zabiha, food with zikr Allah. If children eat that food, iman will come. Amal will come, good deed they will do. So we should be very careful what kitchen we have. We should not eat any junk kind of food. I had many children also here. Don't eat every cookie, everything, please. We have to keep the house mahal Islamic. Every room has TV, mashallah. What do you think? Mommy, daddy watching TV, mommy, daddy watching drama, can you stop the child? No. These American children, they say, mama, why are you watching this? Here I give you a very good point. I recommend you never ever buy cellular telephone to your child until he, she go to college. Not in high school. They don't need it. They have internet. They can do the work on the internet, homework. They need it, right? But you have to block all possible bad avenue, gates in the internet. This is daddy, mommy responsibility. They should use internet in the closed room, not closed room. It should be unlocked. Mommy, daddy can check anytime. What my son, my daughter doing? This is a different topic. I don't want to go this side. Sometime I'll cover it. Only they need Philip telephone. No telephone at all. Cellular telephone to me is a hell phone. Be watchful. YouTube, this tube, that tube. That you cannot control the child. No matter what, he is becoming Hafiz. This cellular telephone destroyed half the Quran. I have this example. Ulama-e-Karam. Very, very strong. The mother lab is the first Islamic madrasa. You hearing me? The mother lab, first Islamic madrasa. He should teach who is Allah. He gave the idea of at-tawheed. He should introduce about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Basic Islamic education. Books are available. Program available. And on the TV, there are certain Islamic program. You can use TV, but you have to control over it. You have to supervise the TV. Be watchful. Children have a lot of questions. Please, parents, I humbly request you, answer their question. Answer their question. Don't say, oh, mera sar kha liya, baitho aram se. What will happen? He will ask somebody else. The children become stubborn. Listen to their children. If you don't know the answer, they ask the ulama. We have to connect ourselves with, like a physical doctor, we have to connect ourselves with some spiritual doctor also, or any ulama-e haq. Do you know that? Which school they go? Sometimes go to the school, surprise visit. High school, child going? Don't tell the child I went to school. Check around. With whom child change the classes? He chatting, talking with a girl? Yes or no? Be watchful. Just go. And we should send the child with the, in the morning, we should give the child to the husband the right halal tayyib nashta, breakfast, and give the food to the child for the school. Or make sure what food they give in the school. We have to introduce the child. What is the purpose of her life? We have to. We teach our proper etiquettes. Sleeping dua, standing up dua, going to washroom with dua, before eating food dua, sleeping dua. All these duas, etiquettes we are supposed to teach our child. I recommend at least two salat we should make with the children in the masjid. In summer, Maghrib, Isha, easily. Winter also, Maghrib and Isha. We can make the masjid of the children. Of course, family also can make it. Why not? And all related Islamic programs. We have to sacrifice the time also. And we should make arrangement for the learning of Quran. The child go 10th grade, high school graduate, he should be able to recite Nazra Quran. And some part of Quran, small ayat, he should become hafiz. Don't just send the child to the madrasa weekend. It is not enough. You should have own daily after Isha, or between Maghrib and Isha, your own small madrasa. The book I recommend, Talimul Haq, written in South Africa, is a beautiful book. Or some other book, As Your Alam, which book is best for it? In every language it is available. Teach yourself. Don't just go take the child to the Sunday school and, lo, Maulana, you do babysitting, we are going to shopping. It won't work. You are going to shopping and Maulana taking as a babysitter. Why don't you stay in the masjid also? Do zikr Allah and learn something. The child will learn it, right? Otherwise, child says, oh, why I should stay? Mommy, daddy, they are enjoying man outside the park and they put him with the Maulvi Sahab. They will hate Maulvi Sahab also. Is the learning important for the children, for adults also? Because Quran says, Ya amanuku anfusakum, save yourself, adult, from hellfire. And primary responsibility, Khokhar should save himself from hellfire. My wife should save herself from hellfire. Then, of course, children also. Everybody going to Jannah. And me, problem. Dawah, tabligh, everybody, right? And no tabligh to me and family. It won't work. We should appreciate the child. If child do what normally we do, if a child does something wrong, we slap him. We are very angry. Oh, why you did it? If does something wrong, so we are very angry. But if he does something good, we don't appreciate it. Same with the wife. 29 days, she cook very good food. We don't say, honey, very good. MashaAllah, jazakallah khair. But one day, by chance, she put more salt. That day we jump up. Your mommy didn't teach you how to cook food, huh? That's the problem with us. We men, I tell you, we men are cheap. You should appreciate the children also. Otherwise, and never ever punish the child. This is not Bangladesh, Pakistan, India. Please, don't punish child. Keep away your hand or stick from the child. Understand? If something happened, blood came out, you will be handcuffed because you have to take to the hospital. You cannot tell lie there. He said, no, child will tell truth. American child will tell truth. In the hospital, you'll be handcuffed. Be watchful. Love your children. Otherwise, the parents who are very hard on the children, what happened? The children get habit of telling lie. They become liar. You understand? Because they're scared of the daddy, right? The girl is scared of mommy. Mommy say, listen, you have any boyfriend? Any boyfriend in the school? Any girl has it. And she's scared. She know if I tell mommy, yes, I have, she will start beating me. She will tell lie. Therefore, if child is loved by daddy or mommy, if mama gave love to her daughter, that daughter will not look love in the school. You understand? I always recommend the mama should be very close friend of her daughter. Daddy should be very close friend of his son. Such friendship, they should tell everything. Mama, hey, what happened? We should get a car guzari every day, 5 minutes, sit down with the child. My dear daughter, how was school today? She can ask question. Did anybody, like any boy like you? Anybody tell you something, any boy? She should tell truth. Mama, yes, one boy say, hello, you look very fine. You look very beauty. So what do you answer? The mama had to child, teach the child, teach the girl. No. He goes in Islamic dress. A mama wear, does not wear Islamic dress. How the child, girl will wear Islamic dress? It won't work. But again, only Islamic dress, hijab is not enough. If your girl going to school with hijab, don't trust 100%. I'm in America in 1970. Worked with the university for 40 years with the kids. I have experience. Don't trust. You understand? They play a game with the hijab. But don't complain also. You have positive thinking, but not negative thinking. Oh, you are bad. No. Trust child also. But let me tell you, mutual friendship of daddy and mommy with the children is very, very important. They will, daddy, the daughter will open everything to the mama. Every day we should have car guzari, what happened to the school. You understand? Preferable Islamic school. Again, Islamic school, you cannot trust 100%. Yes, sir, I tell you frankly. But again, better than non-Islamic school. Of course. So, if child, you punish the child, what will happen? He will suffer anxiety, depression. He will suffer that. Lot of psychological diseases. It's very, very important. The child should, the children introduce them 5 enemies and 5 friends. Who are 5 enemies? We should introduce the child. The children should listen carefully. Who are sitting over here? Whose children are not here? They should tell. We have 5 big enemies. The first big enemy is our nafs. Desire. I want latest cell telephone. Latest car. Ibn al-Riba. Desire. The first is Azazil before Shaitan. Which Shaitan? Misguided Shaitan. His nafs. His nafs makes Shaitan, made Shaitan. Nafs is a big enemy. Second big enemy is our enemy is Shaitan. How to differentiate between Shaitan and Nafs? Nafs taqaza, Nafs desire again and again. If you say, Auzubillah min Shaitan Rahim, Astaghfirullah, Auzubillah, still same taqaza, same demand. That's from nafs. But if any bad idea come, look her, look him. Eat burger, Allah will forgive you. This is from a shaitan. And third enemy, our bad habits. Children, be careful. Make sure parents check it. They should not any bad habit. sleeping too late is a big bad habit. Against prophet advice, sleeping too late, especially weekend. You sleep late, Fajr gone. But daddy, mommy cannot say children, sleep, 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 and they are not sleeping. Mommy, daddy has to become model. And fourth enemy is a bad friend. You tell me your friend, I tell what you are. You understand? Bad friend is a fourth enemy. First big enemy, loves desire, uncontrolled desire. And second enemy is shaitan. Third, our bad habits, personal bad habits, smoking. Testing first, then bad friends. And the fifth big enemy, biggest enemy, you know, social media. Bad use of social media. Cell, telephone, internet. Bad use, I'm telling. Internet you need for homework. The biggest enemy. We have to replace these enemies from friends. Number one, the best friend we should have, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do zikr Allah. Learn Quran. Make salat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will become your friend. Second best friend, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Bring maximum sunnah in the life. In all affairs of the home affairs, daily life, bring maximum sunnah. Prophet will love you. You will love Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Third, pick up right friend. Pick up a right friend. If your son is A-grade student and his friend is a D-grade Dean Dog, right? D-grade student, that student will bring him down to C. Yes or no? You understand by talking? Your son is A-grade student, he should become friend of A+. But not too many friends. No, no, no. Minimize friend. There was a novel I used to, long story. Save me from my friends. Save me? So many friends. I have no time. Even to eat food also. People eat food and talking. No family relationship even. Be friends with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Good friend. Be friend mommy and daddy. And don't become friend of bad part of social media. You should know that. Parents is a responsibility to teach the children. Now, let me tell you a few stories. Who made Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam obedient child? Was ready before daddy. Daddy, go ahead. What Allah commanded you, do it. Ye faizane nazar tha, ya ke maktab ki karamat thi, sikhaye kisne Ismail ko adab-e farzandi. Who trained Ismail alayhi salam? Mother. Ibrahim alayhi salam left her with the child there. Who trained, who made the son obedient? Mother. A mother is Hajra, alayhi salatu wasalam, child will be Ismail. In character. A mother is Fatima, radiallahu ta'ala anha, child will be Hassan and Hussain. Obedient. If child is, a mother is the mother of Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, you know how he became? Short story. He went for education. She hired some dinar. Some, on their way, a robber caught up the kafila, the caravan. They asked child, do you have some money? He said, yes. Where? They check everything. They could not find it. They took him to the leader. He said, this child is strange. He said, I have money, but we cannot find it. He said, where are? Then he said, tear up my part. They found the money. He said, we could not find. Why you told us I have money? He said, my mother told me, never ever tell lie. Always tell truth. Children, listen carefully. Never ever tell lie. Always tell truth. On this child truth, he did, Robert did Tawbah, leader, or Robert did Tawbah, or they became Wali Allah. This is what it is. We should train a child like that. Muinuddin Chishti Rahmatullah Alai. Do you know that? Muinuddin Chishti Rahmatullah Alai, big saint, about 7 million Muslims did Tawbah in his one safar from Delhi to Calcutta. 7 million Muslims did Tawbah. We will not do guna again. And 7 million Hindu became Muslim. Where we are for Hindus became Muslim. When he came back, he told his mommy, Karguzari, mom, this is what happened. Million people became Muslim. Million people became Muslim. He said, my son may not become arrogant in the heart, kibar. She said, Moeen, this is not because of your effort. This is because of your mommy. I, your mother, gave you 2 ear milk on my chest with zikr Allah and with wuzu. You understand? But nowadays we give bottle milk, right? But they don't want to give milk of the chest because chest will become, you know that. That's problem. We don't give milk of the chest, which is the best milk. Child will not love you. Why we love our mothers? We drag the milk. We old people get less sick. Why? We drag the milk of the chest. Yes or no? The last thing to say over here, Ibn Jawzi Rahmatullah, great Muhaddith, great Alam. His auntie, maybe her mother was not present, passed away. His auntie used to take the child when he was 7 years old, 8 years old, 9 years old, to the majalis of the ulama, like these children came over here. So as a result of that, when he became 10 years old, he used to sit on the member like that. 10-year-old child, Ibn Jawzi Rahmatullah, he used to give waaz, nasiha, advice, Islamic lecture. So concludingly, one final rule I'm telling you. Listen, open your ear, which is the foundation how to raise children as good Muslim. Number one, mommy and daddy, husband and wife, should love each other from the heart. Then children will love mommy and daddy. Mommy and daddy, father and mother, should respect each other from the heart. Then children will respect mommy and daddy. Mommy and daddy should obey each other from the heart. Then children will obey mommy and daddy. And last thing, mommy and daddy should forgive each other. Father and mother should forgive, because we are human beings, make a mistake. Then when children see this, they make a mistake, their mommy forgive me please, right? If we present this model, mommy and daddy love each other, respect each other, obey each other, forgive each other, the children will respect both of you, love both of you, obey both of you. You have to work, mommy and daddy have to work their own. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to raise children as good Muslims, to change our life under the Sharia. obey every possible commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,